This is Scientific American's 60 Second Science. I'm Christopher Intagliata. How many U.S. presidents can you name? For most people, researchers have found...
The first couple are remembered like Washington, Adams, and the last couple, Obama, Bush, people like that. But then nothing in between.
New York University's Pascal Wallisch studies what's called neural data science, dealing with the huge amounts of data that come with studying neuronal activity. And he says our recall of presidents is governed by two factors, what's known as the primacy effect, who came first, and the recency effect, that's who's been around lately. He and his colleagues wanted to see if the same type of cultural memory pattern would hold true for pop music.
So the question was, well, is there like a cultural horizon or an event horizon? At what point, like, you know, knowledge of something drops to zero?
So his team asked more than 600 volunteers, most of them millennials, to listen to snippets of Billboard number one hits from 1940 to 2015 and to say whether they'd heard the songs before. Turns out the volunteers barely recognized tunes from the 40s and 50s.
And melt your cold, cold heart.
Suggesting the primacy effect holds for presidents, but not pop music. But the recency effect did seem to hold true, because songs released in the last few years were more recognized than those released in the aughts. But then the recency effect stalled, because rather than continuing to drop in recognition back through the 90s, 80s, 70s, and 60s, songs in that 40-year period saw a steady plateau of recognition among the listeners, within which there was noticeable variability in song recognition, despite the fact that these were all number one hits in their day. For example, some tunes were almost universally recognized, whereas other number ones barely registered. The study and full song list is in the journal PLOS ONE. It's not clear why the study subjects remembered what they did, whether music from the late 20th century had something special about it, or if maybe over-the-air radio DJs influenced the result.
So those are all great questions, and I think they're probably best addressed by doing this again in another 30 years when radio is basically gone, and then we'll see what is like stable and what is not stable about this.
As for Wallisch,
I listen to like the softest pop you can imagine.
And an even more obscure genre.
I like to listen to my data.
Digital music is just numbers after all, and with certain programs you can analyze your data by listening to it. Just don't count on all those numbers turning into number one.
Thanks for listening. For Scientific American's 60 Second Science, I'm Christopher Intagliata.
For the names of all the number one hits you heard, check out the podcast page at scientificamerican.com.